מסכת מנחות, פרק רביעי. We are on page 50, top of the page. We have here Nekudotayim, which is four lines from the top of the page. The Mishnah tells us, לא הקריבו כבש בבוקר, יקריבו בין ארבעים. If the Kohanim somehow, all kind of reasons, did not offer the offering in the morning, daily offering, they should do it in the afternoon as a daily offering. Now, the issue is, Rabbi Shimon tells us in the Mishnah, all of that applies when it was beyond their circumstances, or they are forced to do it. But if it was intentional, they shouldn't do it. Amar Rabbi Shimon, וכולה הייתה קריבה בין הארבעים, אלא שאין מחנכים את מזבח הזהב אלא בקטורת הסמים. רבי שמעון tells us, in a situation like that, the entire measure was offered in the afternoon as a daily service. In those days they used to have a golden altar, is initiated only with the burning of the incense of the spice in the afternoon, at which time they will burn a full measure. So the Gemara asks, Chinuch man dechar shmei. What exactly, when we talk about a initiation of the temple vessels, what exactly the relevance in that to our Mishnah? The Tzon Kodashim and Tosfot expand on that. So, in a way, the way Tosfot said, that how do you know that the golden altar uses a full amount of maneh? So the Gemara said, Chasurei Mechasra, something like the Mishnah is incomplete, Vehachei Ktane, and that's the way it should be teaching. Quote, Lo Yikrivu Keves Baboker, Lo Yikrivu Ben Arbaim. If they did not offer a lamb in the morning, they should do it in the afternoon. Bame Dvarim Amurim, what is this statement applies to? שלא נתחנך המזבח, אבל נתחנך המזבח יקריבו בין ארבעים. All of that applies when the altar has not been initiated, since it must be first be initiated with the daily offering of the morning. However, if the service of the altar had already been initiated, then they should offer the lamb of the daily offering in the afternoon, even though they did not offer the lamb of the morning offering. Amar Rabbi Shimon, Ematai, what's this din apply? Bizman shehayu anusim o shugigim, when the Kohanim were really in a situation that there are circumstances behind their control, or they failed to do it unintentionally, they forget to bring it, they mix up, they couldn't make it in the morning. אבל אם היו מזידים, but if they did it intentionally, ולא הקריבו כבש בבוקר, they didn't do it in the morning, לא יקריבו בין ארבעים. They shouldn't offer a lamb in the afternoon as a daily offering. By contrast, the Mishnah continues, לא הקטירו קטורת בבוקר, if they don't burn, they didn't burn the half measure of the incense in the morning, even intentionally, יקטירו בין ארבעים, they should burn the half measure incense in the afternoon, regardless to their circumstance. So it's important to know that the concept of chinuch, which is in general the idea of beginning, it's a subject that the rabbis disputed. What does that mean, chinuch? There are those who said avodatam mechanchatam, which means the moment they walk for them, they cause their utensils to become too sanctified. And some said it's applied to those that Moshe Rabbeinu did in a desert. The moment he used the oil, Shemen HaMishcha, that sanctified them. There are those who said no, it's applied to those who use later on. There are those who said that it's nothing to do with Kiddush Klei Sharet. It's just commandment to Torah, the same as inauguration of the tabernacle in the Korbanot HaMiluim. And it's only at the beginning of using these utensils, like in the first and the second Beit HaMikdash. But if one of them become unfit, then they fix it, so they don't need to do specifically in this type of avodah. It's important to know that both the Rambam, the Sefer Mitzvot, the Gedol, the Sefer HaChinuch, they do not count the inauguration of the altar in the list of the mitzvot, and apparently the way they said it, this idea of chinuch is nothing to do with hechsher keilim, the approval of the utensils, but the idea is that the Torah commanded that they started the avodah, the rite, the service in the morning offering, tamid shel shachar. And it's not independent mitzvah, but part, chelek, medinei avodat ha-korbanot, part of the daily avodah, the daily offering. Chidushi Agriz, Mikdash David, Zohar Akiya, and Megillat Esther, Sefer HaMitzvot, they hold that. Anyway, so Gemara said, Mena Nemile, from where we derive that if the lamb of daily offering of the morning was not sanctified, say it was basically somehow was not used as a serve in a service of the new altar, it not yet be initiated, then the lamb of the afternoon is also not offered. The Tanu Rabbanan, if you zoom in the pasuk in Shmot 29 verse 39. Et hakeves echad ta'aseh ba'boker, the one lamb you shall offer in the morning, and listen carefully, ve'et hakeves ha'sheini ta'aseh ben ha'arbaim, and the second lamb you shall offer in the afternoon. What does that mean? Sheini ben ha'arbaim, the second lamb of the daily offering, is offered in the afternoon, ve'lo rishon ben ha'arbaim, but the first one, it may not be offered in the afternoon. Amar Rabbi Shimon, Ematai, the Braita continues. Since the Pasuk refers to the afternoon daily offering as the second lamb, it cannot be offered if no other offering preceded, or the way Rashi said that the second half of the Pasuk is conditional upon the first half, so that the Pasuk states that if the one lamb you shall offer in the morning, then and only then the second lamb you shall offer in the afternoon. B'me dvarim amurim, when is all this applied? When? שלא נתחנך המזבח. So they didn't use it, וזה אשר תעשה למזבח עם תמיד של שחר. So Rashi explained that this verse is interpreted as referring to the first or second offering ever offered on the altar, because the previous pasuk is referring to the inauguration of the altar, because if you look at the pasuk in Exodus 29, now this is that which you shall offer upon the altar. אבל נתחנך המזבח, but if the service of the altar had already been initiated, אפילו ראשון בין הארבעים, then even if it is the first to be offered that day, it should be offered in the afternoon. אומר רבי שמעון, ממתי בזמן שהיו נוסעים ושוגגים, as we said earlier, אבל היו מזידים, לא יקריבו כבש בבוקר, כי לא יקריבו בין ארבעים, לא יקטירו קטורת בבוקר, יקטירו בין ארבעים. So the Gemara ask, in that sense, וכי כהנים חטאו מזבח בטל, because the כהנים sin by intentionally failing to offer in the morning, daily offering, the altar should be entirely idle. אמר רב אחי, כי אמר לו, יקריבו אין, אבל אחרים יקריבו. They should not offer the afternoon daily offering, but other כהנים should offer it. Because the Gemara in Yuma 26 said that the Mishmeret, those who did it in the morning, usually do it in the afternoon, but in the case not. That's a special knas, a special fine. Shita Mikubetzet, Piskei Arit said, that this Chachamim imposed upon them. לא יקטירו קטורת בבוקר, יקטירו בין ארבעים. So the Gemara said, the reason for this is, דחייבן דלא שכיחה ומאתרה, since the burning the incense is uncommon and cause those who do so to become wealthy, chavivalu, it's dear to the kohanim, velo pashe, and they are not negligent in the performance of this rite. Omar Rabbi Shimon, Omar Rabbi Shimon, that's by the way, yasimu ktora be'apecha, that's the wealth, ברך השם חלו. Anyway, אומר רבי שמעון בחולה את הקרבה בין ארבעים שהם מחנכים את מזבח הזהב ולבקטורת הסמים של בין ארבעים, that's the Mishnah. So the Gemara ask, והתניה, learn a brighta, בקטורת הסמים של שחר, that the incense of the spices of the morning. So the Gemara answer, and it said תנאי, it's a disputation among the תנאים. אומר רבי, מסתברא, it's more logical reasoning that the הלכה should be the command of Rabbi Ktorah the Simim Shal Ben Arbaim, the one who said that these incense of the spices in the afternoon, because it's written, Dechtiv, Baboker, Baboker, every morning, Beit Yivoyet Anirot Yaktirena, when he dresses the lamp, he shall burn it. Ilav Da'avar Adlaka Me'uta, Atava V'Tzafra Me'echa, if the Kohen did not perform the lightning of the lamp the previous evening, from where will the ashes be removed in the morning? So what you see here, we see a clear proof that the candle burn must have been lit for the first time in the evening. And since the Pasuk states, when Aharon lights the lamp at dusk, he shall burn it, a perpetual incense before God, it must be that the incense was burned for the first time in the evening. ולמאן דאמר בקטורת הסמים של שחר, and one who says that the service of the new golden altar is initiated with the burning of the incense of the spices in the morning, from where is the brighta derives, גמר ממזבח העולה, he derived from the altar of the burnt offering. מה להלן בתמיד של שחר, אף כאן בקטורת הסמים של שחר. Just as there is the daily offering of the morning, so here too is the incense of the spices of the morning. נגמור עשר ולא את השולחן אלא בלחם הפנים בשבת. And use of a new table was initiated only with the arrangement of the shoe bread on Shabbat. אלא בכל יחנוכי הודלה מחנך הקידושי מקדיש. But does the Mishnah mean to indicate that if the shoe bread was placed on the table on a weekday, is merely that the use of a new table is not initiated, but the shoe bread is sanctified. Because the halacha is that the shoebread is sanctified only when it's placed on the table on Shabbat. So he gufa kamashmelan. That's din himself come to teach us the chinuch v'kiddush de shulchan b'shabbat hu. So they said that the initiation of the new table and the sanctification of the shoebread when it's placed on the table occurred only on Shabbat. Big question Yashar V'Tov asked when they're building the Mishkan, the tabernacle. So Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu in Shmot chapter 40, ve'evet ad ha-shulchan ve'arachta et erko. So since the Gemara in Shabbat 27b said that the erection of the tabernacle happened on Sunday, how come the Shulchan inaugurated that day? So the Sifrim Bamidbar 28 in Yeshar V'Tov brought the Tosefta that this commandment is not applied to the day of the inauguration of the tabernacle, but the first Shabbat that followed. Kiniktanei Seifa, as we learn in the later clause with regard to initiation of the use of the new candleburn, they said in the last part of the Mishnah, ולא איתם נורא, אלא בשבעה נרותיה בין הארבעים. And the use of the new candleburn was initiated only with the kindling of its seven lamps in the afternoon. It's a big question. It means only Ben Arbaim or can be also others. Say, Emek HaNatziv, Yashar V'Tov and Sfat Emet deal with this question. Tanur Rabbanan. Now it's a bright time when Vav to Ktoret, to incense. Zehu Ktoret she'alta liyachid al mizbeach hachitzon. This is incense that was offered for an individual rather than community on the external altar and not on the golden altar as usual. And it was only a provincial edict, it's called Ra'at Sha'aita, just by force of circumstance, otherwise it never happened again. Heicha, when this, to what case in this braita referring? Amar Rav Papa, Rav Papa said, that's applied to what? Bansi'im, to the incense brought by the tribal princes at the inauguration of the tabernacle. You see in the book of Numbers, chapter 7. So, the book Or HaYashar, he wrote, לכאורה מלשון והוראת שעה הייתה, because of the language here, the Gemara said והוראת שעה, משמע דברית הזו סבירה לכשמואל, לאל יוטט עמוד ב', it means that this bride that follows שמואל on page 19b, דלא ילפינן דורות משעה. ולפי זה יש לדקדק, ביש למה יאהבו סבירה לדי רבי ילפינן מדורות לשעה, ואם גם לא היה לן כל הנקרא ידם הייתה בברייתא בסמוך, למעט בן יחיד בן ציבור על מזבח הפנימי ולא מזבח רצון, ואז הרי המקום למילף מהנקרא יתר לדורות. אבל אחרי דעית לך כל הנקרא לאיסור, אם כן, מהי דאבה הבא? And in short, after a long מהלך, he said, ואולי יש לומר דווקא משום דעית לנה נקרא אלה איסורה במקום להקשות קרא ידעה ולהחשמין ולנסים הוראת שעה איתה. Anyway, whole concept of הוראת שעה, it's also you see in שיר השירים, chapter 5, they said, באתי לגני, אכלתי ירעים דבשי, so Rashi said, קני סוכר, ומרוב חביבות אכלתי הסוכר עם עץ הקנה עצמו. So explain, you see it also in Meshech Chochmah, that says that in the Siyim, it was something that was there and not ledorot, not the future, שהכתירו יחיד כתורת על מזבח החיצון והתקבלה. וזהו פלא, because in that the very day, what happened the first of Nisan David? Nadav and Abihu, what happened? Right?
Yes.
They burned, they died. They brought Ketoret Zara, Ketoret Yachid before Hashem. So the Meshech Chochma in Parshat Korach, you bring the Midrash, the Midbar Rabbah, Yud Gimel, that he said, what Vayihi HaMakriv Bayom Rishon, who is now in Festival of Sukkot, right? You see Vayihi. We know Vayihi is what? Lishon Tzar. So he said, הולכים להישרף במחלוקת של קורח. כמו שאמר ראשי העדה, שאלו אלו הם אנשים על ייצור בן שדור וחבריו. Why? Because it was, הדעת הם הוראת שעה, שנתקבל הכתורת שלהם ברצון, versus נדב ואביהו, שנשרפו באש, אשר יצא מפני השם, this fire consumed from heaven. Why? Because it was alien fire. So that's the reason that caused them to think that they are more important than the other Kohanim, and Hashem chosen them to serve him, so therefore they disputed, לכן איך לקרוא, אמרו שביחד עם קורח ונשרפו. אז זה משך חוכמה. Anyway. היכה, אמר הפאבה בן סיים. It's fascinating to think the connection always between the daf and now it's חול המועד. בסוכות.
That's true.
Amazing, huh? אל היחיד על מזבח החיצון הוא דלו. יחיד not bring כתורת. אז זה הוראת שעה. העל מזבח פנימי מקריב, even יחיד, even individual bring כתורת. ותו, and furthermore, על מזבח חיצון יחיד הוא דלה. על ציבור נקרבו, by the community, no offering incense on the external altar, והתניה. Learning the Braita, another Braita, יכול להיריח אם מתנדב מביא כיוצא בנדבה. May happen because the Ketoret brought on the golden altar twice a day, that's Rabbeinu Gershom said. So you may say that individual may voluntarily donate and bring incense similar to the incense brought by the tribal princes to the temple as a gift offering. וקורא אני בא מוצא שפתיך תשמור ועשית, what the Ketoret said in Deuteronomy 23, מוצא שפתיך תשמור ועשית כאשר נדבת, whatever come out of your lips you shall observe. So as a result, תלמוד לומר, לא תעלו עליו כתורת זרה. Torah said that you shall not, you shall bring no strange incense thereon, which means that an individual may not offer incense even on an inner altar. See the Ramban and also Targum Onkelus on that. Yachol oyei yachid mevi. So you may think that individual may not bring a gift incense on the inner altar, as individual does not bring an obligatory offering similar to this gift of incense. She'en mevi chovato kayotzeba. Since an individual is never obligated to offer incense, he may not voluntarily offer instance either, that's the way Rashi explained. Page 50b, אבל ציבור יהם מביא, it says, but when it's come to ציבור, which is the community, may bring incense as a gift offering, obviously as a community, where on the inner altar, they said shemevi chova kayotze ba, which is does bring its obligatory offering similar to this, which is since the community is obligate to offer incense, it can also voluntarily offer incense, and it's important, that's Rashi, so important to read the Rashi here. I'd like to share with you the Rashi at the beginning of Vayikra, Perek Aleph, Pasuk Bet. Dibur HaMatchil Korbanchem. Rashi said, let me just read the first the translation of the Pasuk. Daber al bnei Yisrael v'amart alehem, speak to children of Israel and say to them, Adam ki yakrim lechem, when a person from among you will bring an offering to Almighty, from the animal, from the cattle, and from the flax, you should bring your offering at Korbanchem. Korbanchem. So Rashi bring more in Shavuos, page 12, and Rashi said, Korbanchem, your offering, melamed, this teaches us, shehi va'al nidva tzibur, that the ola offering, the burn offering, can come as a voluntary contribution of the entire community, because you shall bring offer, your offering sounds redundant. So the verse could have simply said, you shall offer, and your offering will have been understood. So the Torah nonetheless wrote Korbanchem, your offering, with plural suffix, chem, your, to teach us that there can be voluntarily communal ola offering, Be'er Yitzchak explained. So he said, he olat keitz hamizbeach, this is the burn, the ola offering of the desert of the mizbeach, of the altar, keitz hamizbeach are fruits which are dried in the summertime, often eaten as a dessert. The dessert of the mizbeach consisted of ola offerings purchased from the communal funds, well, these were offered on the mizbeach when no other offerings were being bought. You see on the book of Shmuel, second book of Shmuel, chapter 16, Rashi there. Also, it's Gemara in Sukkah 56. So they said, the olat kaitz ha-mizbeach, this is the olah offering of the dessert of the mizbeach, the altar, haba'a min ha-motarot, which come from the extra funds. So that's the Gemara in Shmuel 12 that said that certain sin offering and guilt offerings that cannot be offered on the mizbeach are sold when they develop a blemish. The fund, listen to this, the funds are then given to the Beit HaMikdash, the Holy Temple, for voluntarily offering. That's the Kaitz HaMizbeach. It is from these extra funds that the dessert of the Mizbeach is purchased. You see also in the Yuma 55b, Rashi, also is a Mishnah in Shkalim, Perek Dalet, Mishnah Dalet. So, anyway, Talmud Lomar, so therefore the Torah, the Pasuk stated in Shmuel chapter 30, verse 9, Lo ta'alu, you shall not bring strange incense thereon. Ta'alu is plural. Plural, so the Shita Mekubetzet and the Ravid. And others said that because the Pasuk, the verse, formulates the prohibition with the plural word, Ta'alu, that's a clear indication that even the community may not offer incense as a voluntarily gift offering. Yachol lo ya'alu al mizbeach ha'pnimi. The Braita continues, one might have thought that the community may not bring a gift offering of incense on the inner altar. Aval, however, ya'alu al mizbeach ha'chitzon, you may bring incense on the external altar. So therefore, Talmud Lomar, the Torah teaches us, the Pasuk in Exodus 31, verse 11, Et shemen ha-mishcha ve'et ktoret ha-samim la-kodesh kechol asher tziviticha ya'asu, and the anointing oil and the incense of sweet spices for the sacred place, according to all that I have commanded you, shall they do. We derive from that, אין לך אלא מה שאמור בעניין. So it's only what states clearly here. כתורת המפורשת בתורה, the Torah spelled out lucidly, that the community obligation, חובת ציבור, it offer on the inner altar versus voluntarily incense, it's not offer even on the outer altar. You see more on that in both Olat Shlomo and Sfat Emet, expand on that. But regardless, what we derive from that in this Braita, that incense may offer only by the community, only when they are an obligation to sacrifice it, and it must be burned only in the inner altar. So that's basically the opposite to what we said earlier, that it is permitted to burn the incense of an individual on the golden altar, or the incense of a community on the outer altar. There is a lat and shita mekubetzet here, or lat shlomo here. Anyway, Amar Rav Papa, Rav Papa reconciled this contradiction. Lo mi ba'aya ka'amar. This braita is speaking, utilizing the style of it is not necessary. Lo mi ba'aya tzibur al mizbeach ha'chitzon de lo ashkechan. It's uncommon, it's not necessary to state that the community may not offer incense on the external hall, as we have not found a precedent for it. Nothing happened earlier that we can support this notion. In the inner altar, individual may not offer incense because we have not found something that happened early on that. But even prohibited for individual to offer incense on the external altar, despite the fact that we have ostensibly found a precedent for this situation in the case of the tribal princes, Bansi'im. Why? Because as we said earlier, Hu'at Sha'aita, it was a provincial edict, and therefore cannot serve as a precedent. So the whole idea of the concept Hu'at Sha'a, it explains several incidents that describe in the Tanakh that do not conform to permanent halachic guidelines. Famous one, David, you remember the story of Boaz and Ruth? Hora'at Sha'a. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Right? So that's not halachic guidelines, some of which occurred when the pretendent halacha had not yet been given to the Jewish people. In these instances, a specific mitzvah was given as a temporary measure, and the Jewish people acted on it, but practical halakha cannot be derived from it. So there are also some examples of provincial edicts instituted by the sages when the exceptionally unique needs of the time required acting more leniently or more strictly than the halakha generally allowed or required. The principle derived from the pasuk in the book of Tehillim, chapter 119, it is a time to act for the Lord, they have made void your law. So they dictated that at time even Torah law may be violated in order to uphold the Torah, Mishnah. Chavitei Kohen Gadol. So it's important to know that the Kohen HaGadol Me'echav, right, is the one we all look upon on Yom Kippur, right? Mm-hmm. But it's also something Kohen Gadol on a daily basis. Every day, kol yom, machatzit baboker, machatzit ba'erev, it's a minchat chavitin ba'machavat. It's the 12 loaves of a matzah prepared for a tenth of a fowl, flour, of the griddle cake offering of the Kohen Gadol did not come from the house of the Kohen Gadol, lo ayu ba'in chatzain, in halves. Rather, el amevi isaron shalem v'chotzeu, the Kohen Gadol brings from his house a complete tenth of a fowl flour, that's Leviticus chapter 6, and he divided it in a half, makriv mechza babuker u'mechza ben arbaim, he offer half in the morning and half in the afternoon. Kohen Gadol shemevi mechza shacharit umet, rare situation, but can be. Kohen Gadol brought a half in the morning and then passed away. Uminu Kohen acher tachtav, and they appointed another Kohen Gadol in his stead. So the replacement of Kohen Gadol should neither bring half of a tenth of a far flour from his house, nor offer the remaining half of the tenth of a far of his predecessor. לא יביא יסרון מביתו וחצי יסרונו של ראשון, אלא מביא יסרון שלם וחוצר. But rather he brings from his house an entire tenth of an ephah and divided it in half. מקריב מחצה, he offer half, ומחצה עבד, and the other half is not offer, it's kind of lost. נמצאו, consequently, what you have here, שני חצאים, קריבים, two halves of the tenth of ephah are offer, one half of what was brought by each Kohen, ושני חצאים of din, and the other two half are lost. Gemara. That's the source of the Mishnah. Tanu Rabbanan. Ilu ne'emar mincha machatzit, a meal offering perpetually, half in the morning and half in the evening, hayiti omer, so I may will say then, מביא חצי יסרון מביתו שחרית ומקריב. חצי יסרון מביתו ערבית ומקריב. Bring morning half an offer, half a tenth of a fine in the afternoon and offer it. Talmud lomar, so therefore we derive from the pasuk in Leviticus 6 verse 13, מחציתה בבוקר ומחציתה בארץ, מחצה שלו ומקריבה, כיצד מביא יסרון שלם וחוצהו, מקריב מחצה בבוקר ומחצה בין ארבעים. נתמה, in the situation that half of the tenth of Eifah was supposed to be offered in the afternoon become impure, נתמה מחצה של בין ארבעים, משה עבד, it's lost, יכול מביא חצי יסרון בתור רביד ויקריב, תלמוד לומר, מחציתה בבוקר ומחציתה בערב, מחצה שלם משלם ומביא. Which means he brings half of a complete ten of ephah. Hakeitzad, what exactly he does to make it happen? Mevi yisaron shalem. Some said mi beito vechotzeu. Makriv mechza, umechza avad. Dimtzu shnei chatzayim krevin, ushnei chatzayim another two half of din lost. Kohen gadol shekriv mechza shacharit umet uminu acher dachtav. Yachol yavi chetzi yisaron beito chetzi yisaronu shel rishon. Talmud lomar umachatzita ba'erev. מחצה משלם ומביא ומקריב. הכיצד מביא יסרון שלם וחוצר ומקריב ומחצה עבד. נמצאו שני חצאים עובדים ושני חצאים קריבים. So you have here the two or halves of the ten of ephah that are lost. You saw a sage, תנא תנא כמד רב נחמן, we told the bride before רב נחמן, מחצה ראשון ומחצה שני תהיו בארצותם ויצאו לשריפה. אומר לרב נחמן, בשלמה ראשון יחזה להקרבה, אלא שני למה לאיבוד צורה. מעיקר לאיבוד קהתי. דאמר לך, מני, תנא דבר רבא אבו ההוא, דאמר אפילו פיגול טעון איבוד צורה. רבא, שאמר אפילו תמר רבנן, כיוון דבידנא דפליג בהו, איבא היה מקריב, ואיבא היה מקריב, מי חזה חזו. So, ידמר חביתי כהן גדול כיצד הוא סינות הרבי אבא רבא אמר רבי יוחנן אופה ואחר כך מתגנה רבי יאסי אמר רבי חנן מתגנה ואחר כך אופה he fried it first in the pan and the afternoon he bakes it in an oven אומר רבי אבא רבא כבתי דידי מסתברא תופיני תאפן הנאה רבי יאסי אמר כבתי דידי מסתברא תופיני תאפן הנאה after being fried כתנאי תופיני תאפן הנאה רבי אומר תאפן הנאה רבי יוסי אומר תאפן הרבה איתלנה ואית לנאה. You have those who go this way, you have to go this, that way. So the Rashi have several pirushim.